Hello friends, Dan from Slashdance. New album out. It's on every streaming platform. There's a link below to get it on vinyl if that's more your thing. There's a music video out and there's a new music video that is in the can and ready to go. So something to look forward to for you kids that like the goth and industrial rock. While we're waiting, I have this giant box of VHS tapes that has been waiting for me at the United States border for over a year. I collect VHS tapes and shipping from the United States to Canada is absolutely brutal. So I have a mailbox on the United States side. I would get a whole bunch of packages shipped there. And then every couple months, I would go down that way or a family member would go down that way and we would just pick them up, saving me hundreds and hundreds of dollars in shipping because nothing ruins your $4 VHS purchase like $27 shipping to get it across the border. The only thing is, I don't remember what's in here. I order a lot of stuff, and this was all ordered in October, November, December 2019, maybe even January 2020. Could be anything. So I thought it'd be fun to open this up with you guys, and we could see what's in it together. Just to kind of give us a bit of a ballpark idea what we're expecting in here, I do collect some somewhat specific genres. I collect 1980s slashers, pretty trashy ones. I don't have the world's biggest collection. I just said I want to get like my 200 favorite and I'm almost there. So I'm not sure how many horror movies are going to be in here, but you never know. There could be some. I collect 80s and 90s anime. Most of it I've had since the 90s, like hundreds of tapes I just didn't get rid of. Now I just buy any anime tapes that I don't own. I like weird exercise videos. Any weird exercise videos I might pick up. Whether or not I bother to get any ship depends on the situation. These 1980s sex comedies, I guess, boner jams, that's what we call them. But like these bad double entendre sex comedies.
Do I play Pac-Man?
General interest, like this is a video game, tips and tricks. And this one here is about how rock and roll will lead you to Satan and stuff. Anything general interest and weird like that, I'm usually game for. So those would be kind of like the five types of videos that I expect to find in here. So without further ado, let's find out what's in this box. Let's see what we got. Anime. There is definitely some anime. Oh yeah. There is five Project Aiko tapes. 1, 2, 3. Stay up. No, you're not. Of course you're not. We mean 4. And 5. Were there 6? Were there 6 Project Aikos? I don't remember, but you know what's funny? And kind of amazing. You? 3 of these are completely sealed. Like they're absolutely brand new sealed Project Aikos. The question will be, will I open these Project Aikos to watch them? Everybody's all geeked up because they found the master film for Project Aiko and they're gonna make a 4K version from the original film. And I don't know, I've got these and that's good enough for me. So hey, that's a good start. What is this? Takegami, Guardian of Darkness, volumes 1 through 3, from the creator of Battle Arena, Toshinden. I honestly, Takegami, I don't remember Takegami. Chances are I was just saw anime I don't own, and maybe it was like somebody had Project Aiko and also had these for like a couple bucks. So I said, why not? So Takegami, tell me about Takegami, Guardian of Darkness, if you're a big fan. And speaking of a big fan, I am a big fan of, and I'm sure some of you are too, Revolutionary Girl Utena x4. That's awesome. Is that the whole set? I should have checked. Well, I didn't know what was in here. So I think it was 4. I think it's a whole series, but 2 are dubbed and 2 are subbed. I think I saw it dubbed in the first place, so that's okay. Oh, and it's one of these that you, that all 4 of them make a little mural. I love that. All right. Man, this is off to a good start. Couple bangers. Dark Warrior 1 and 2. I don't remember these. One genetically engineered gladiator. The rivers will flow with blood. Judgment Day is at hand. Dark Warrior. This is like one of those things I would have saw at like Blockbuster and like not even rented. I just would have got Ranma or something. But anyway, I now own them. So Dark Warrior, the rivers will flow with blood. So oh, here's a good series. Or at least good to own. It might be good. I don't remember. I haven't seen it since the 90s. You got to be careful what you say is good. It is the entire set of Heroic Legend of Arislan. Arislan? Arislan. I'm sure everybody pronounces it differently and someone will correct me. But yeah, Heroic Legend of Arislan. I think that's the whole set. Does this have a cool side thing? No. Parts 1, part 2, part 3, and 4. I think that's the whole thing. So, dubbed. So much anime on VHS was dubbed. It was just like, it's kind of a rare treat to get it subtitled. I remember when Gundam came out subtitled. We were all super excited, but you did what you had to do back then. So I kind of have a soft spot in my heart for 90s dubs.
But if this is justice, then I'm a banana.
Landlock, parts 1 and 2. You know, you get cool Shiro art, but I've never seen Landlock. Feels like Attack on Order. Is it good? It's by Manga Entertainment. They were pretty touch and go. My favorite thing about this is that Manga Man is on it. I miss Manga Man. I'm happy to have a VHS tape with Manga Man on it. A lot of these still seem to have their plastic, so. Kishin Core. Haven't seen that in a long time. Let me make some more room here. Covering up my own merchandise here, but that's okay. These are by Pioneer. They're in these giant clamshells. Are these like bootlegs? Or are they real? No, they're real. Usually when you get a case like this, they're subtitled, and yep, sure enough. Subtitled in English. 1, 2, and 3. I don't know if that's a whole series. I'll have to look. What's next? There's 3 that match, and it's Video Girl Eye. All right. This might be one of my new favorites that we found. Man, this is awesome. I first saw this on like a fan sub tape. You get these EP fan subs that would have like Dragon Half, the second episode of Macross 2, and then Video Girl Eye. And then you'd watch them and you'd just be happy to have them. And that's how I saw them. I'm not even sure if I've seen the whole series. I probably have. We probably watched it since then, whenever it came out on DVD. Read the comics in Animerica magazine. Did any of you read the comics in Animerica? It's got one of these, which I love. Boom. Right there. Get you a mural. Some Video Girl Eye. Boo! The original release of Vampire Hunter D. I've got like that newer release. I think ADV put it out or something, like the black cover. This art is infinitely better. This is how I remember. The case is a little bit beat up, but like this is, when I think of Vampire Hunter D, this is what I think of. Great anime. I love the music. Really violent. A lot of fun. I like this better than the sequel. This is my Vampire Hunter D. Stoked. Streamline. I love Streamline. I got such a soft spot in my heart for Streamline. Well, I'm a huge Yurutsuki Doji fan. I've got the soundtracks. I own a cell. I think I've got the old crappy anime 18 manga. Here's the movies 1 and 2. I've already got them. These look like they're in way better shape than mine because they're still sort of in the plastic. But clearly, I had ordered it because right there. The OAVs. I never owned the OAVs. I never bought any of the sets with them. I've only ever had the movies. I'm sure I've seen them somewhere. But anyway, I was really stoked to own them. I know the series kind of goes off the ledge, which is saying something because, you know, it's sort of not that good. But it's definitely was a missing piece of my Yurutsuki Doji collection. What is this? Genesis Survivor Gaia Earth. Gaia Earth? Gaia Earth. I don't know. That's a deep cut for me. I do not remember that one. You kind of have to remember, I'm like from a really small city. So it was like, anime was like a miracle to get a hold of. It was just like, you had the basic stuff at Blockbuster. Then you had like a more hardcore nerd shop that had like slightly, like you could get Nadesco there, but you had to buy it. You know, so sometimes I didn't see everything. And then, yeah, so Gaia Earth, I don't know. That one must have slipped by me, but I saw it, and now I have three tapes of it. So Genesis, Survivor, Gaia Earth. You can never go wrong with any anime like Genesis Climber, Neon Genesis. Genesis was huge in the 90s. Let me know. Is that good? Should I watch it? I mean, I'll probably watch it, but let me know what I'm in for. Here's a one-off. The Legend of Lion, Flare 1 and 2. Ooh, adult animation from the creators of Guy. I don't know what that is. Guy. For mature audiences only, this video contains nudity and extremely explicit depictions of graphic sex and violence that may offend some viewers. Oh, the tape is blue. I'm like, forget the graphic sex and violence. Look how cool this tape is. You know what's kind of creepy is this is like an adult animation and it's like stopped halfway through. So was that like the person watching it was just like, ah, done with this. Gross. Guy, The Awakening of the Devil. It's Flare 1 and 2 from the creators of Guy. And then here's Guy. The ultimate in science friction. See, that sold me. I love a good double entendre. So yeah, second target. Some guys have all the luck. Oh man, look, this tape's red. Here's a title I'm surprised I didn't own already, but I'm glad I do now. So yeah, I was missing Shiro's Appleseed. Yeah, so there's a classic, Appleseed. Like pretty common, you know, it's put out by manga. Everybody's seen that one. Oh. How would you describe your megalopolis? Well, hopefully your megalopolis is not doomed. It is the doomed megalopolis. It's adjacent to the Demon City Shinjuku. It's in Japanese on this side. Devil Man Lady. Are they Japanese cases? That's what it looks like. That or their bootlegs. But the side labels have copyrights and stuff on them. There is like a scan code on the side, so maybe they're just Japanese copies of them. I'm not super familiar. I don't have that many tapes from Japan. So if anybody has the proper Japanese Devilman Lady VHS tapes, let me know if those are right or if they're just fan sub bootlegs. So I think that's it. I should show you guys my Devilman jacket I bought in Tokyo 10 minutes before the pandemic hit. Look at that. Yeah. It's got Devilman embroidered on the back. It's got the Devilman logo in the exact same spot that Glenn Danzig has a logo tattooed on his lower back. There's Devilman on the arms, Akira here on the front. And I don't know, it was just cool. It just came out around the same time as Devilman Crybaby. So maybe I just got lucky. So yeah. It's a bit of a filler this week because I was hoping that the music video would be out, but it's a little bit out of my hands. But at the same time, I still had a super fun time opening up all this old anime VHS. I didn't know it was only going to be anime, but I'm kind of glad that it was because I love anime tapes and they're not always that easy to get. So come find me on social media. Hit the bell button and the subscribe button for notifications so we can see each other again. I love y'all, and I'll talk to you next week.